Hi guys, my name is Anurag, and in this video, I'm going to be talking about fuels and heats of reaction, which is chapter 13 of the Leaving Cert course. Organic chemistry is a branch of chemistry that involves the study of carbon compounds. Each family of a compound of carbon are called a homologous series. Homologous series are basically compounds that have the same general formula, similar properties, and differ from each other by a step of CH2. The ones I'll be discussing in this video are alkanes, alkenes, and alkynes. Alkanes have the general formula CnH2n plus 2. In this formula, if you substitute the number of carbons in your compound, you'll get the molecular formula of the alkane that corresponds to the number of carbon atoms you put in. Alkanes are said to be saturated. In chemistry, this means that they only have single bonds. Each carbon atom in alkanes is also seen to have a tetrahedral structure. If you see a molecular formula for a compound, it tells you the number of atoms in each molecule, but a structural formula provides more detail. It actually shows how the compound is bonded together. Now for the property of alkane compounds. At room temperature, the ones with few carbon atoms are gases, but as the chain gets longer, the compounds are liquids at room temperature. For alkanes with more than 12 carbon atoms, they're like solids. For example, lubricating oil. Alkanes don't dissolve in water, but they dissolve in nonpolar substances, like cyclohexane. All alkanes burn in oxygen to produce CO2 gas and water vapor. Once again, they're saturated, which means no double or triple bonds, only single bonds. So far, we've discussed alkanes. Alkanes are aliphatic hydrocarbons, but what does that mean? It means that they don't have a benzene ring. However, aromatic hydrocarbons do have a benzene ring. Alkenes have the general formula CnH2n, and they always have a double bond. The smallest member is ethene, which has two carbons in it. We discussed structural isomers earlier in this video. Here are the structural isomers of butene. Now, you might be wondering why there's a 1 and a 2 in their names at the bottom. This basically tells you where the double bond in the molecule is. In bute-1-ene, it's on the first carbon, and on bute-2-ene, it's on the second. Now for alkynes, our final homologous series. These have the general formula CnH2n minus 2. They always have a triple bond, and their smallest member is ethyne. Like most hydrocarbons, ethyne gas burns in air to form CO2 and water vapor. Ethyne is also called acetylene gas, and it's used in instruments like the oxyacetylene torch for cutting and welding. A benzene ring has single and double bonds, and this kind of bonding is called an intermediate bond. There's a diagram of a benzene molecule at the bottom right-hand corner. Methylbenzene is an aromatic hydrocarbon. It's used in explosives like TNT. Crude oil is a mixture of different hydrocarbons that need to be separated in order to be useful. The mixture is separated by fractional distillation. Step 1. Crude oil is heated in a furnace where it's evaporated. Step 2. Then the vapor passes through a fractionating tower from the bottom. Step 3. Compounds condense at different fractions. This is totally dependent on their chain length and boiling points. Higher boiling points condense at the bottom, and lower boiling points condense higher up. These are the six fractions in the fractionating tower, along with the number of carbon atoms a compound in that fraction would have. Refinery gas is used for bottled gas, LPG. Gasoline is used for motor fuel, petrol. Naphtha is used for making chemicals and petrol. Kerosene is jet fuel. Gas oil is used for motor fuel. Don't confuse gas oil with gasoline. They're really different things. Natural gas is mainly made of methane. It's very explosive, which is why smelly compounds called mercaptans are added to it so you can detect any leaks instantly. For an engine to work, you need a spark at regular intervals. If you get a spark before the desired moment, you get a detonation sound. This remarks knocking. The octane number of a fuel describes its tendency to cause knocking. When a scale was being made for this, heptane and 224 trimethylpentane were chosen. Heptane is equal to 0, and 224 trimethylpentane is equal to 100. You can add stuff to petrol to increase its octane number. Lead compounds raise the octane number, but they're really bad for the environment because of their toxic fumes. An example of a lead compound is tetraethyl lead. Oxygenates, on the other hand, are better additives because they raise the octane number, but they're not that bad for the environment. An example of this is MTBE, which stands for methyl tertiary butyl ether. A change in structural features also increases the octane number. Short chains, branch chains, ring structures, and aromatic hydrocarbons have high octane numbers. Straight chains are heated in presence of a suitable catalyst, which converts them into branch chains. This is called isomerization, as it makes different isomers of each compound. Large chains are broken down into smaller ones by catalytic cracking. Dehydrocyclization forms ring compounds and some hydrogen gas.